Hey there, guys. This is Dilapidated. Today I'm going to be showing off Dav90's Hash Collider. And so I think you guys are really going to like this tool. It comes in handy with reverse engineering as well as with these YMT files and figuring out the real strengths for what they pertain to, okay? And so I'd like to show off a few demonstrations on how this works. Really, before you begin, you want to grab the YMT files that Dav has converted conveniently to XML. And so I went ahead and I navigated over to the VFX vehicle info.ymt file because personally I really enjoy working with effects. So once you come over here to this file, I want to point out a few things about how Grand Theft Auto works and why this is an important tool for us. So first off, Grand Theft Auto uses what is known as a Jenkins one at a time hash. And so a lot of people refer to it either as Jenkins only or a JOAT. And what that is a string that is converted into a hash using that JOAT algorithm, okay? Now, in a YMT files, we don't know exactly what the real string is for certain items, all right? We only know what the collided hash is. Now, the thing with JOATs are that more than one string can have the same exact hash, all right? So it's really difficult to find the real true string at times. And as you can see here, we do know the real string for a lot of these items here. Knowing the real string allows you to really utilize how this file works and understand it. Without knowing that, you just get things like string with that hash or string with that hash. You know, we really don't know what that's pertaining to. We have no clue. We can make our best judgment based upon what we see here, but we really don't know what the real string is, all right? So when you come down here, to show an example, let's take a look. All right, so we see a lot of these parameters here are just collisions, okay? So we really don't know what the real string is on these. And so I've went ahead, I've copied all of these. So you can copy, you know, this string right here, the whole entire thing, and go through each one until you've copied them all. And then once you have them, you're gonna add them over here to the hashing tool here. All right, so you'll add them there and you'll choose add hashes. All right. Now, the thing to note, the way that Dav has done these, you could actually just take the middle section here, which is only the hex if you wanted to, and you could just add the hex. Now, you would have to change this over here to hex if you wanted to do that. As you notice, right here is this, and it matches that. Now, you can't add it because it's already been added by the strings. Anywho, so once this is there, we want to figure out what the real string could be. So to figure out what the real string is, we're going to go over here to resolve missing names, all right? And once we click resolve missing names, we're going to get a pop-up here, and it's going to showcase pretty much what we're going to be searching for, okay? So with the knowledge that we've gained, and you know, there's a lot of things here that we can figure out. So if you look above, you'll notice that these begin with boat. All of these begin with boat, okay? Boat. And the next word is a capital letter, but it begins with boat. So knowing that, what we can do here is we'll start it off with boat. We know it starts with boat, and we know that after that, the next word is going to be a capital first word, okay? Now, we're just going to use Grand Theft Auto grab words for this search. Using the English dictionary will give more results. Sometimes those results may be a little bit useless because it's just putting random stuff together. So what we're going to do is we're going to start the search here, and then once we start that search, it's going to start finding a bunch of different items here for us. And we'll let that run just for a little bit. I won't let it run too long, but we're just going to let it find a few things here. And once it's found a couple items, I'm going to go ahead and show you exactly what you can do with that. Now, the important thing is once you find these, you're really not going to know for sure without 100%, you know, accuracy if that's the real string, you know, unless you do some research, you add it, and it makes sense. In which case, then we can confirm, hey, it's boat zoom, toxic, slice, whatever, you know. So we can add it in there, and then that would be accepted over here. So you could take one of these. All right, you could take this one, for example, and you could copy it, and you could replace this hash with that string, any of these strings. Anywho, we'll go ahead and we'll stop the search here, and we'll just select these. Now, we know, of course, some of these aren't correct for the real string. All right, there we go. So once you add these, as you can see, that hash here, the Jenkins hash here, would equal this string there, okay? Now, these are probably not the actual strings, like I said, and some of them are very well, we know that they're not. Anywho, that's basically how it would work. There's a few different ways that you can go about this. So once you had a giant list, you could go over here and you could say copy all grouped, and you could go over and you could paste these. And let's actually do the whole entire group. Let's do all. So let's see, select all and then copy grouped. Select all and copy grouped. And we'll just throw that in here. And there you go. So this over here is that the hash. And this is all in hex. And this over here is all in decimal. Okay. You can use either one of these, they're both the same. And this lets you narrow it down. So once you have a giant list, you can actually come back here later on and figure out which strings would be equal to the hex or the decimal. Okay. And that can help you narrow down and make lists to figure these out. So that's pretty much how this would work. I wanted to show another demonstration to how it can help people that like to reverse engineer. So for this, I have IDA pulled up, and I'll go over to it now. So for this, say that we wanted to figure out what this byte is referring to, what hash. So let's go ahead and make this into data, so that way we can grab the hex. And yeah, there we go. So we grab the hex. We want to copy this. And we'll go back over to our tool. Now we're going to go ahead and delete all this for now. And let's add the hex. Now you got to make sure it says hex here in order to add it. So on the fly, we should be able to figure out what this hex is referring to with reverse engineering. So when we add it, we can see that this was referring to ped population frame rate. And so it's very convenient to be able to track this information down and figure out exactly what these hexes and Jenkins hashes are referring to. And this tool allows us to go through quickly, figure all this data out, and also guess and resolve missing names as well. So if we could all put our minds together and open these YMT files up and track down these collisions, over time we could figure out every real string. And so as a community, this would definitely help us out in making better mods, finding information out that we presumed were hard capped or non-editable. And so this is really good for us, and I hope that this tutorial helps out and gives you a better understanding of how it works.